fact that if you love your wife, you would go shopping with them. Why make it mandatory then? That's a question that they haven't answered. But before that, we believe that if you really want to understand your wife or your husband, go lock yourself in the room and have fun, right? Don't think you think that that's the problem coming from them. They seem to be the ones that reduce these divorce cases, right? We have three responses to that. Actually, firstly, we think that divorces is fine because it's a way to escape from your relationship. But more than that, right, we think that under your paradigm, more divorces will happen now. Because why? If people don't want to watch football, if I don't want to go shopping with my wife, I can't get out of it, right? We think that thirdly, divorces won't happen under our paradigm because you will learn to accept your wife naturally and not through the forcing of the government. Now, let's see the third thing, the second thing they talk about, right? How football is a major aspect of a guy's life. Three responses also. Firstly, this is not an absolute idea. We have different kind of guys in society. But secondly, what if I accept that my husband likes football, but then he also accepts the fact that I don't have to watch football with him, right? It's a mutual agreement. What is then going to happen? Then he will tell you, ESPN will now lose business because these people who like football won't want their wives to come and watch it with them, right? Now, thirdly, let's look at the idea of their counter-proposal and how they're going to have counseling for these people. Two questions, right? Counseling is subjective. I can lie in counseling. What is then going to happen? Because the results are not absolute. Secondly, we tell you that to face a professional psychologist, it takes you a lot of money. Who is then going to bear for all this cost when you're going to give psychology, you're going to give counseling to all the men who's married in the country, right? Yes.
Are you going to sacrifice the betterment of your nation, the betterment of the relationship to your nation, just because of money?
Ma'am, we don't think this would cause any betterment. We think for betterment, it should happen naturally under your own incentive, right? Sure, you should understand the nature of love. Okay, now, let's move on to the third idea for today on how people get to spend more time and they understand about their partner even more. Four responses in that. Firstly, you don't understand your partner even more. Go to a room, get a room. Secondly, there are other alternatives to this, right? Go have a picnic or something like this. But the first thing that they never answered is why make this thing mandatory, which is a very big part of this debate, right? Because we believe that the government can't just intervene in your personal choices. Third response is that marriage works under a concession-based basis, right? Where both parties concede to the fact and they understand and they realize. That is when real love happens and not forced love, right? Now, with that, tackle the case of side government. Moving on to my case today. We feel that there's no problem in status quo. That is why you see Tim's and Lavanya's relationship working out fine, right? That's why we can sleep with status quo. We feel that relationships are based on mutual trust and faith. It's a natural process that should happen, right? We feel that the government don't have the right to intervene and tell you what's wrong and what's right in your relationship because they've never done that in status quo. So now, what's our goal? What are we trying to achieve here? We want a sustainable relationship, right? We want something that happens naturally. We want the two parties to acknowledge personal choices because we feel that is when real love happens, right? What is our stance coming from side opposition? We are fine if you want to watch football with your husband, but we don't think it should be mandatory. The burden that they have to answer, which is a big one for them because PM didn't clear that, is why does the government have the right to intervene in your personal choices and why it is mandatory, right? Now, I have two things to talk to you about today. Firstly, the whole idea of the nature of marriage. Secondly, I'm going to talk about the rights of these people. And thirdly, I'll tell you, when can the state actually intervene in your personal choices, right? It doesn't mean the 21st century, when all marriages, most of the marriages are based on love marriages, right? The process of getting into a relationship is complex. You don't just jumpstart into a relationship. It's not a master-servant relationship. There's a process on where you get to know the person, on where you go on dates and stuff like that, right? That's when you build a strong relationship, where there's mutual understanding, acceptance, and acknowledgement for certain things that you like and certain things that you don't like. That is when you come to a consensus to sign an agreement with the government and mutual agreement, accepting differences and coming to a consensus and not all these forces upon you, right? We think that when there's forces, when there's external pressure on you and when you don't want to do something and the government goes against this, that is when you disturb this natural process of marriages, right? That is when harms happen because it goes against the whole nature of love and marriage. Under our paradigm, it is different. Why? Because both parties Naturally, ladies and gentlemen. With that, we're proud to oppose this.